So, my name's Chase, and this is going to be my first video on this channel. Okay, so recently there's been a lot of films that are like book to movie adaptation. I don't think there's ever been a film adaptation of a book where they've kept everything in the story. I figured, you know, why not do a few videos on different books that I've read and the differences for the film. So, a small while back, a film came out called City of Bones. And it's based on the Mortal Instruments book series. This is book two because I don't own book one. This is called City of Ashes. I own the six in the series, the Mortal Instruments series, but there's a film made of the first one, and there's going to be a TV show called Shadowhunters coming out in January, which I'm really excited about. Okay, let's get started. Clary's hair colour. On this model is clearly meant to be Clary, and her hair colour, right, is ginger. Her hair is, like, you know, described as, like, fiery orange kind of thing. She has freckles, all that kind of stuff. And what colour is it in the film? Brownish red. And then there was Alec. Alec Lightwood was meant to look 1 year younger than me. He's 17. How old was the actor? The actor was about 35. He's around 28, I think, when they filmed it, or something along those lines. But he definitely did not look 17. Magnus, however, in my opinion, looked perfect. But Godfrey Gao, sweetheart, he couldn't act very well. I'm sorry, I love him. Simon turns into a rat at Magnus's party. That never happened. Raphael was not in the film. Raphael Santiago is a Spanish, I think? He's kind of Spanish. He's Latino, I think. Or Hispanic. He speaks Spanish. He's a vampire, and he's awesome, and he knows Magnus, and he's great, and he was not in the film. Hodge, also in the film, was old. Hodge is meant to be around, I think, 2 years younger than Jocelyn, and Jocelyn is not an old woman. Also, something that they're actually doing in the TV show as well that kind of annoys me, when they say Shadowhunters are half human, half angel, and they're not. They're a human bloodline with, like, maybe a couple of drops of angel blood in them. They're not half angel, that wouldn't make sense. The reason Jace and Clary are so special is because they have slightly more angel blood in them, which gives them more powers kind of thing. If everyone was half angel, that would be ridiculous. They have Seraph Blade. In the books, they have names. All the Seraph Blades have names, and they're all the names of angels. You call forth the name of the angel, the Seraph Blade lights up, and then you stab. But in the film and in the TV show, they don't have names. In the TV show, they look a bit like lightsabers. In the books, the institutes that the Shadowhunters sort of live in, kind of thing, they're on hallowed ground. Demons cannot enter. In the film, a load of demons enter. In the film, there's a portal in the institute, and that's like a very special thing, and that's incorporated in a bunch of the scenes. That isn't in the book. There's a portal at Madame Dorothea's house. That's in the film, I think. Wait, that isn't in the film, is it? There's a portal at Madame Dorothea's house. I don't think that's in the film. Also, Church. So Church is the cat that lives at the Institute. He was owned by James Carstairs. Well, he was rescued by James Carstairs. And he was taken to the New York Institute and then stolen back by James Carstairs. He is a fluffy blue-grey cat, and he hisses at everyone, and he kind of hates everyone. But at the same time, he's the Institute cat, and he's just there, and he's adorable. Max. Was Max in the film? Oh my god, Max wasn't in the film. Oh my god. Max Lightwood is Alec and Isabel's little brother. He likes manga. He's adorable. He's nice. He's cute. And he wasn't in the film. Their parents weren't in the film as well. They have two parents. Like most people. Called Robert and Maurice Lightwood. And also in the film, there's a scene with a Rottweiler that turns into like a demon thing. That is not in the book. Valentine. His hair is a sin in that film. He had fucking rat tail dreadlocks. Was it dreadlocks or was it just a braid? Either way, they were... In the books, Valentine is conventionally attractive. He is pale, he has white hair. Did he look anything like that in the film? No, he was a freaky, weird rat tail man. In the books, Isabel's whip, the weird coil bracelet thing, that's not books. Alec, Magnus, Magnic? What the f- Malik. There was no Malik. And I was very disappointed in that because Malik is one of my OTPs. There was a tiny bit of Malik when Magnus was like, but just because of the heart one or whatever he said. And I was just like, what? I meant who? The one with the blue eyes. In the book, Magnus tells Alec to call him, and Alec sort of stutters before Isabel sort of drags him away. That's at the end of the party as well, that's in the party scene. There is much more Malik in the books. Vampire motorcycles. They were not in the film. Jace takes Clary for a ride on a vampire motorcycle. Also, something that I found really weird about the film. English accents. Just why? I mean, sure, okay, everyone likes English accents, apparently, in America. I wasn't surprised that was Valentine English? I need to look this up, because if Valentine was English, I would not be surprised, because the bad guys are always English in American films, come on. Okay, it won't load, so I don't know if Valentine was English or not. But yeah, Jace, Alec, and Izzy, they were all English for some reason. Like, okay, your actors are English, but so is Don Sherwood, and he's being Jace in the Shadowhunters TV show. And he's doing an American accent for that because it doesn't make any sense for Jace to be English. It's never said that they have an English accent in the books. And they have no reason to have an English accent because they've lived in America their whole life. Also, the way the film ended did not leave any sort of room for a sequel. Also, the book has actual funny bits in it that aren't really awkward and cringy. Like, they didn't take many actual direct quotes from the book. But I remember the only quote that I remember that they did take directly from the book is the one where Clary wakes up in the institute and Jace is there and she's like, is this the part where you take off your shirt and use it as a bandage or whatever, I don't know, or use it to dress my wounds or whatever she said. And in the book you read it and it's like, and then in the film you listen to it and it's like, is that just me? That was probably just me. Also, why was Magnus wearing no pants? I'm not complaining. Also, there's no tackies. In the books, there is a restaurant called Tackies. I'm not sure if it's in the first film, in the first book. I'm pretty sure it is though, because it's in like all the others. And it's like a Downworlder sort of cafe restaurant type thing. Oh yes, Simon! Simon isn't in a band! He's not in a band in the film. In the books, he has a band, but the name of the band is always changing. They're always trying to think of a new name for a band. And Simon has a groupie called Maureen, but she isn't in it. So I hope I managed to get all the important bits at least, you know. Feel free to comment down below, but please don't just comment a million things that I missed. Because I know I will have missed some things. I'm very sorry. I want to try and do a few more videos in this kind of series thing. I want to do Harry Potter. I'm probably going to do Twilight or something. I might do The Hunger Games, maybe. I might do Divergent, maybe. I want to do How to Train Your Dragon, because I love those books. I might do Vampire Academy. I might even do some anime and manga differences. When I finally read Interview with the Vampire, I might do that. And when Shadowhunters comes out, I might do one for Shadowhunters and the books as well to sort of compare. So feel free to like, maybe subscribe, comment down below, whatever, all that kind of thing if this didn't bore you. Because it's good enough for me. So yeah, ciao!